Shadows are falling and I'm running out of breath. Keep me in your heart for a while. If I leave you, it doesn't mean I love you any less. Keep me in your heart for a while. When you get up in the morning and you see that crazy sun, keep me in your heart for a while. There's a train leaving nightly called when all is said and done. Keep me in your heart for a while.
Hey guys, so as you know, yesterday, if you watched that video, I was out here in the barn. I was doing some tool organization, and I tried to light this wood furnace that I bought here. I bought this thing a few months ago, and it's homemade. It's all made out of quarter-inch steel, and I want to go over what's kind of happening with it. So let me turn this camera around, and we'll get at it. All right, so this thing has always had a draft issue. And but lately, I've noticed that I have to have the dampers set on the lowest setting and this one slightly turned in order for this chimney here not to smoke. So what it's doing is it's drafting so poorly that around every single joint, I'm getting smoke coming out really bad. So I almost wonder if up here is, it kind of goes from 6 to 8 and then outside it goes from 8 to 6 and then goes up. And I'm kind of wondering if I've got a large buildup or something blocking it in the chimney. So the first thing I want to do is pull these screws out, pull that off and take a look down inside of there. Like I said, this thing's always had a drafting problem. And so I think what I really need to do is I need to pull this 6-inch coupler off of here, whatever you want to call that, and put an 8 and just vent this thing with an 8-inch. Because what I think is happening is this firebox is so big inside that it creates more smoke than the chimney can handle. I think that's what's going on with it. underneath these bricks here, there's a grate, and that all used to be open. So I put those bricks in to lessen the space in the firebox, and believe it or not, that helped by probably, you know, 30% or so, I would say. So I wasn't, before, anytime you crack this door at all, it would be pouring smoke out. But now I can have that door cracked probably about an inch and it'll just draft from the door. So let me set you guys up. I'm gonna get up there and pull that pipe and we'll see what we find. Well, there is some crap in there. I think that might be what's causing our issue right at that 90. So let me grab you guys. I'll bring you up here and show you. I got to get this kind of out of the way first, though. All right, so I got that out of the way, and I got my flashlight down in there. I'm going to put you guys in the hole here. And if you look down inside of there, you can see a pile of garbage there. That's the 90 where it goes up. And I think that is restricting us that much to where it does not want to draft correctly. So what I'm going to do is grab a shop vac and see if I can clean all that out. And I think that'll solve our issue. Interesting. I didn't realize I should have put a T there. I was going to, but then I thought, no, I didn't take into account how dirty this fireplace burns. It doesn't burn efficiently. So
you know, it is what it is. We'll change it later when I make it an 8-inch.
All right, so I got my shop vac here. Let's go ahead and see if we can get this thing, whatever that is down there, get it out. So this is what I was able to pull out of there. That is creosote. You can tell how black it is underneath that. So I think that creosote was probably blocking our flow. I know, like I said, it doesn't, has never worked properly, but I've never had as much trouble keeping a fire going as I did. So I want to go ahead and we'll put that pipe back on, get that shop vac off of it, and let's light a fire and see what happens. All right, I got it loaded up. We're gonna go ahead and get it burning here. Close that off. And let's see if we get any smoke out of them pipes. Well, it's still smoking, so I guess I'm just not going to be able to use this wood stove. All right, so what we're going to do is, obviously, I mean, this is burning right now, so I'm going to take advantage of it. But I think what we're going to have to do is pull this stuff out of the way. I've got this wood stove here. And originally what I did was I took this one out and refinished it. I repainted it and everything. And I put this one in because it's much larger. And it heats the shop better. But obviously I can't use it now if it's gonna be leaking like that. So I'm going to reinstall this one. And I guess in summertime or sooner, we'll see. I'll cut this 6-inch piece off of there. We'll put an 8-inch flue and see if it works any better. It's gotta be a draft issue because it doesn't have enough cubic inches inside that pipe to actually exhaust the smoke the way it needs to. So let's go ahead and I guess start changing this out. All right, so I got it all disconnected. I pushed over. I'm going to leave it right there. It's not going to hurt anything. I got this wood stove put where it's going to be. It's directly above the hole. So I just need to take the pipe over here. That's not enough, but I have a couple more pieces out in the box truck. And get it run. I'm confident this one works very well. It just wasn't big enough for this area, but I think I'll just have to burn it hot and sometime spring, summer, we'll go ahead and address the flue on that one. So I'll go ahead and get those pipes cut, put in, and we'll light a fire and get it burning. One more thing about these pipes is, if you look down in there, they really need cleaned out. And I'd been looking for my brush for some time now, and I just found it. I thought maybe I loaned it out and somebody had it. I couldn't remember who, but first thing we're gonna do before we get them pipes put on is I'm gonna hold them over this trash can and we're gonna clean them out individually and start over, so. All right, we'll start with this one here. You know, before I do that, I'm going to get some gloves on. See what's happening? All Now this one has the flue in it, so I gotta do it from both directions here.
So I got two pieces on here, and then I realized I've got a problem. When I go up and I make the 90, coming off of that 90, because the way this old one worked here, I put the pipe over this whole thing here. So basically the part that, the side that wasn't crimped went over that. On this stove, you can't do that. You have to have the crimped side down, which then presents the problem of I need one of these only in the stovepipe. I could use this, but it's there. This stuff is thinner, and I don't know if I really want to take the chance. So I got a couple options. I can go to town and I can buy one tomorrow, or I've got this pipe crimp tool. I could make my own. So I'm gonna sit on this for a few minutes. I'm gonna think about it and figure out what I wanna do. I may just go ahead and make my own, but I'm kind of worried about that because I want it to be a good tight fit, and I'm not so sure I can make that happen with these. So more than likely what I'll end up doing is just going to town and buying one of those pieces. And we'll just finish this up tomorrow.
Well, it's the next morning. Lowe's opens at 6. So we're gonna head on over and pick that up, that adapter. It's about 23 degrees out right now. We got quite a bit of snow on the ground. And so let's head on out.
Here kind of looks like they're closed, but they said they opened at 6, so I guess they're not. Let's head on in.
Thinking that's it. Here we go. Here we go. That's what I need. Perfect. Here's something good to know. They sell individual shop vac pieces, adapters and stuff. I don't know how many times I've needed something like that and I couldn't find it. It's a great idea. Here's the larger size. All right, back in the car. I'm gonna stop at the gas station, get me a coffee, and head on home. All right, so I got that piece in. I've got those two lined up pretty good. So I just have to cut a section of pipe. I'm gonna go ahead and cut it out of this one here. Yesterday I did throw some paint on this section here. I've got all the clearances correct. It's 24 inches to the pipe. The back is 18 inches off, which is what it called for. I am going to put some cement board with an air gap behind it going all the way up. I'm going to move these out of the way. And so let's go ahead and get that piece measured and cut, stick it in, and then we can light a fire and warm it up in here. It's cold outside. All right, so the way we're gonna do this, I've made a mark here. It's at 17 9/16. I'm gonna periodically go around this and put a mark at that measurement. Till I get back to the other side. Now, if you had something that was flexible and it was a straight edge, had a nice straight edge on it, I mean, you could take that and wrap it around on this mark until your edges meet, and that would give you a nice straight surface to cut. So now that it's like that, I'm gonna go ahead and grab something a little bit flexible so I can finish making my line. All right, zip tie it is. So we have our line. I'm gonna go ahead and cut it off. And I'm just gonna use a 4.5-inch angle grinder here. First, let me get some hearing protection. All right, next thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna grab a file and I'm gonna clean that edge up. We don't wanna get cut. Now, that's the outside. The inside, if you look at this, has a rounded edge on it. That's why I grabbed this one. We're gonna clean the burrs off of the inside now. There we go. Go put it on. All right, I got it all put in. I want to give you guys a couple tips. I always put around every joint, I will put 3 self-tapping screws. And the reason I do that is because when this pipe warms up and expands, and I want to show you something here on the back. So I put one here. Back when I had this in my old house, this pipe would heat up so much that it would start rising, and it went straight through the ceiling, but this pipe would start rising up out of here and it would damn near come out of this collar. So I had to drill a hole in this and put a screw in just to hold it in place. So it's a really good idea to put at least 3 screws around every seam. It kind of holds it together and you won't have to worry about it when you leave. The other thing is down here, I've got some high heat paint, and there's a couple different kinds you can get. You got this barbecue grill one, which I think is like 1200 degrees is what it'll go up to before it starts burning off. I wouldn't use that. This is more expensive, but you're looking at a ceramic coating and it's 2000 degrees. This is by far the best heat paint you can get for wood stoves that I've found. Stay away from this stuff. It'll just smoke your house up when you light it up. This stuff does not smoke. At least it hasn't for me. I haven't had any smoke come off of anything I've painted with that. So there's tip number 2. Tip number 3 is sometimes back here on these seams where they join together, you're gonna have a gap and you'll get a little bit of smoke coming out if it's not drafting properly. What you can do is take some tin foil and just, you know, roll it down or flatten it down and shove it down inside of here and take up that space. That's a good way to seal that up. A lot of people will use that high temp
mortar. I think it's a mortar. I've done that, and it just eventually cracks out, and it doesn't hold in there. But aluminum foil will. So let's see here. I'm going to go ahead, and I painted all the way up to this joint. I'm going to go ahead and paint the rest of that, make it look pretty decent. That piece up there that I installed from Lowe's is going to smoke. It's got that 1200 degree paint on it. It's going to just going to have to be what it is. But I'm going to go ahead and finish painting the rest of this, and then we'll come back and light a fire.
All right, we're ready to light a fire. I got everything kind of staged in there, so let's see how it goes.
So it's definitely burning really well. Temperature's coming up. I'm gonna pop this door open just a hair here a little bit. I closed it, but we'll let that get a little bit hotter. But that's burning really nice. I can tell you that this is an Ashley wood stove, and this stove burns extremely efficient. It's probably, I'd say, about 10 to 12 years old now. And it's been great for me ever since we bought it. I want to go outside and take a look at this chimney and just see what it looks like coming out. If I know this stove, there's probably not a whole lot of smoke. And it hasn't been going but maybe 5 minutes. So let's see what we got here. I had that ladder over there because I cleaned it out before I fired it up. Yeah, there's not much smoke at all there, is there? Looks like more heat. One thing I can say about this old homemade wood stove is it burns very dirty. That thing is smoking nonstop. It just, something isn't right with it, but we're gonna investigate it and figure it out. I wanna make it so it works a lot better. And when I do, we'll go over kind of what it looked like when I got it. I got some pictures, what I had to do to it to make it right. Had a lot of rust on it. I mean, I spent a half a day getting rust off of it. I put a new gasket in it, you know, all that stuff. So we'll talk about that. But anyway, I want to see how this heats the barn. It's supposed to heat up to 1,600 square feet, I believe. It's bigger than the ones that you can get now that say up to 1,600 square feet. So I'm guessing it'll do a little more than that. These new ones you get are tiny. If they have that kind of a square foot rating, but we're gonna see. This barn is not insulated the best. It's just basically got OSB, and behind it is like a 3/4 inch sheet of just styrofoam. And eventually that'll change. I'll be putting R30 in or R38 in the walls. The ceiling does have a little bit of blown in, but we're gonna go ahead and blow more in. I wanna make sure this barn is very well sealed up. The other problem I've got, if you come over here with me, is the doors. They have a gap at the bottom, and I put a new seal in, and the seal is just not big enough. What happened is the concrete outside has dropped, and it's created this open void on all the doors. So at some point we'll get bigger seals and put on them. I'll get this door cleaned up. It'll look a lot better. Maybe paint it, and you know, all in time. So anyway, if you like the video, please like, comment, subscribe to me. I've got a lot of good projects coming up. I want to share it with you guys, and we'll see you on the next video.